Which of the two would you actually choose?
I'm sure Valentino will choose the left one.
Oh, Gigi Delinha or Alberto Pudge? So it's bon dia. Welcome along to MotoGP Guru and welcome to the Catalan Grand Prix of 2023. Jack Appoyard with us here in the studio. What a privilege. We can't believe this is only the second half of the season starting now.
I know, unbelievable. We've just completed 10 of the 20 rounds from here up until the end of November. It's going to be pretty hectic.
And you're not going to be at home for about 2 months, I don't think.
Yeah, I've got my suitcase ready in the corner of my bedroom, ready to go, but excited for it. It's going to kick into gear the business end of the season. This is where the championships are decided, so can't wait to get stuck in.
And there's going to be a lot of predictions to be made. You already know how it works, of course. So do I. I think I remember, but it's as easy as this. So, MotoGPGuru.com, top right, play now.
Does all this work, though? Talk us through it.
It's pretty straightforward, actually. All you need to do is click on Make Predictions. As you can see, there's one there for basically every session coming up throughout the weekend. Pick a rider and then save predictions.
So it's four this week. Four gurus more than ever on one programme. Nick Harris and Jorge Lorenzo joining us as well from their respective homes in Oxford and Switzerland. Hello, gentlemen. Jorge, how's it all going?
Hello guys, how are you? Getting ready for my last race in the Porsche Super Cup this weekend in Monza.
Yeah, fingers crossed with that. That's a spectacular place as well. And Nick, Catalunya, of course, one of Jorge's best ever circuits with 6 wins, his second best circuit after any Mugello, and some great races there.
Yeah, and of course, Jorge's won on the Yamaha and the Ducati in Barcelona. But I think if you think of Barcelona, you think of Jorge, you just think of some unbelievable races, close finishes, mostly going in Jorge's favour. One in particular didn't, but I think of Jorge and Barcelona almost as one thing.
Yeah, we might be seeing one of those races, I think, in a bit, but we'll come to that in a while. First of all, let's get on to our predictions. But before the predictions, we've got the new guru pick now, and we'll start with Nick Harris to put him on the spot first of all. So basically, Nick, all you need to do is just, we're going to put you on the spot and just choose one or the other. Okay, we've got a 2003 Honda or the 2023 Ducati. So it's one or the other. Which would you rather have?
Oh, the Ducati, without a doubt. Yeah, so successful. They're so successful this season, and a big four-stroke, okay? Must be. When I was younger, I would have loved it. Now, too old.
I'm surprised that Nick didn't go for the Honda there.
Yeah, I thought he might.
Iconic bike. And if we're looking at liveries as well, with the number 46 in yellow on the front, it's one of the most standout bikes in Grand Prix history.
Would it be on pole position this weekend, though, Nicholas? That's the question. Let's kick it off.
As you know, and I've made it very clear, I just don't want to pick Pecco Bagnaia every time. And Jorge Martin's got a decent record in Barcelona, decent record in qualifying. So let's be a bit different. Jorge Martin.
Okay, from one Jorge to another, Mr. Lorenzo, what do you reckon for pole position this weekend?
I will go to Pecco this time. I think he's very strong mentally. He has a lot of self-confidence after so many wins. So he's also a very explosive rider, so I think he can get the pole position.
Mr. Appoyard.
I've checked the forecast, and I know we're a little bit, a couple of days out, but apparently there's going to be some showers on Saturday morning. So I'm going to go Alex Marquez for pole position.
Whoa.
A couple of times this season. Of course, he was on pole in Argentina when we had a little bit of wet weather. Of course, took sprint victory at Silverstone in similar conditions as well. So I think if the rain falls, we could see Alex Marquez on pole for, of course, his home Grand Prix.
Nick's going to have a go, but I'm going to go Pecco Bagnaia for pole. I'm not going to say it for all three, although I will just say I did get it right.
Although
I did get it all right for sure, so that's all I'm going to say there. But yeah, that's
well,
what I'm going to
do. Well, not difficult, was it? It's just put his name for everything.
Let's move on to our next guru pick. Jorge, we've got one for you now. I don't know what we're going to get here, but basically one or the other. So guru pick for Jorge Lorenzo the first. What have we got? Oh, Gigi Delinha or Alberto Pudge? That's putting you on the spot.
Delinha is more into the engineer part, and Alberto is more into the management part. So it's difficult to compare. But Delinha, he always got a point in me as a rider. So I would say Gigi.
Jorge, what do you reckon for the sprint? You're a 68-time Grand Prix winner, 6 victories at Catalunya, 5 in MotoGP.
Well, in the sprint, there are some specialized riders. So I will put Jorge Martin again. I normally put him for the sprint. So again, I will put him for the win in the sprint.
Okay, what do you reckon?
Sorry, Nick. Pecco Bagnaia for sprint victory for me.
Nick, quickly, sprints, what do you reckon?
Dear.
You're going to go Bagnaia, aren't you?
I've gone for Pecco. I have, yeah. That's why I've kept my mouth shut for the last 5 minutes.
Okay, well, I'm going to do something a bit different. It's his home Grand Prix. I think he's got to make up for that embarrassment last year when he lost that second place by slowing a lap too soon. So I'm going to go Aleix Espargaró for the sprint.
Not a bad one, not a bad one.
Yeah, and all those long sweeping corners. Do you want your first MotoGP pick? You've
not
had one before.
Go on. Throw one at me.
Let's have the first MotoGP pick for Jack Appleyard. What are we going to get? Let's have a look. We've got video. Okay, so a couple of overtakes then from the last Grand Prix. Frankie Morbidelli on Pol Espargaró. That was a good one at the Graz curve. Okay.
And then what's this? Matt Marquez, who's it on? Is it Jack Miller?
Yeah. Yes.
Very similar to the one that Fabio Quartararo pulled off last year. I think I'm going to go with Morbidelli, though.
Let's kick off with our predictions. Mr. Appleyard, we'll go with you first for this.
Am I going first? Okay.
How's the weather on Sunday? Do you know?
Again, my extremely accurate weather forecast tells me that there's going to be yet more rain on Sunday.
Really?
So I am definitely going outside the box on this one. I don't think there's been a man on the grid with more bad luck all year. His fortunes are finally going to change on Sunday in Barcelona. Miguel Oliveira.
Really?
Catalan Grand Prix winner. He's strong in the rain. We saw what he was able to do last year in both Thailand and Indonesia. When he has finished Grand Prix or sprints this year, he's been very competitive.
I'll do mine then. I was going to say Pecco Bagnaia, but now I'm not sure. No, I would say Pecco Bagnaia, whether it rains or not. I think it...
Come on, sorry.
I just think that's what's going to happen. We'll change the subject. Nick?
A night out with Gregory Hines. That'd be good fun, wouldn't it? Blimey. I've gone for Aleix Espargaró because he made the mistake last year. He's been in good form. We saw him win at Silverstone. And the Aprilia, I think, would be pretty useful there. So I'm going for Aleix Espargaró.
Okay, Jorge, you're the rider, you're the star, you know best.
I think for a long race distance, Pecco have the more chances. Then we will see because, maybe Aprilia have more traction. Maybe KTM have a very good setup during all the weekend and is stronger. But I think Pecco have more chances. I will go for Pecco. I think it's a good track for Ducati and his riding style. So Pecco is the safest option for me.
Another guru pick then for Jorge, and I know what's coming. We know what's coming on this one, don't we? We've got a couple of videos to watch. So I'm not sure how to describe this, Jorge. I guess which is not quite so bad is maybe the way to put it. But let's have a look at these videos. This guru pick.
Don't tell me 2009. Don't tell me.
Let's find out.
It had to be. It had to be.
Yeah, well. It's unbelievable move from Valentino. Then I did it again in the straight and then I closed the gap for avoid the same happen with Valentino. This was the last lap. I tried to close all the gaps in all the corners, but this time Valentino, too fast. And here, unbelievable, he make an impossible action to me, but he didn't want to lose that race to me. So he just say, okay, I try everything. I try to risk everything, or I win, or both of us are outside the track and crash.
Okay, well, that was the first one.
Yeah.
Here's the second one. Let's have a look. Oh, yeah, this is painful. This is painful.
Mamma mia. Many times happened actually in that track. I remember Julian Simon happened in 1-5 or, 1-5.
Which of the two would you actually choose?
I'm sure Valentino will choose the left one, but not myself.
Yeah.
For sure, I feel very sorry for Aleix, so I wouldn't choose any one of it. I think I will choose Barcelona 2009 because even if I lose the race, I think is one of the more spectacular battles in MotoGP history.
Yeah. With amazing overtakes from both of you. Okay, talking of overtakes, let's do the best comeback. Jorge, we'll start with you. Who will gain the most positions on Sunday in Barcelona from where they start on the grid to where they finish at the checkered flag in the Grand Prix? This is difficult, isn't it?
Always tough.
Yeah.
Normally, I would say Binder, but Binder is improving a lot his qualifications on the qualifying. So now he started quite well, first, second row. So then if you start so well, you cannot recover so much positions. So I will go to the safest one, that is Augusto Fernández, who have this ability to recover many positions. And I hope he will be strong also this weekend on that.
Okay, well, I think I'm going to go Miguel Oliveira. I'm going to say something's going to go wrong in qualifying, and then he's going to charge through the field spectacularly. So you might possibly to win.
Okay.
But that means I have to buy you a drink, so I'm not sure. Maybe to second.
Okay, well.
You know, just gain a load of positions. I'll go Oliveira. Who are you going to go for?
I'll go Enea Bastianini.
Ah, so you think he's going to qualify badly?
Yeah.
Well, he's been struggling of late. That's true, really. He hasn't got the shoulder injury that's plaguing him anymore, but just can't seem to get settled on this 2023 Ducati. So I think it could well be that he maybe struggles on Saturday, could find a breakthrough in the sprint, and then romps his way through the field on Sunday.
And Nick, who's going to gain the most positions? Pecco Bagnaia, you're going to say, aren't you?
Fabio Quartararo, great record at the circuit, obviously struggling with the Yamaha at the moment, but he sticks at the task throughout the race, and I think he'll pick up a lot of places.
Can you believe that he won here 12 months ago? Yeah. How long ago does that feel? Yeah. And by 6 seconds as well. I think
it's unbelievable.
I'd buy everybody a drink if Fabio wins by 6 seconds on Sunday. I mean, that feels like such a long time ago.
Just before we go then, Jorge, how's it all going with the car racing? Are you pleased with your progress?
Not as big progress as I would like, but I'm getting better.
Okay, well, good luck. Fingers crossed for the rest of the season. And thanks to you, Jorge. Nick, what's
Thank
the plan
so
for you over the weekend? Are you going to be probably with a beer in the pub watching the race, aren't you?
I don't know about with a beer in the pub. I certainly have been watching the race. I've just come back from the Isle of Man, the birthplace of Grand Prix motorcycle racing, which is always interesting. And settle down like Jack. Jack's going to be all over the world. We'll be settling in, and some very, very busy weekends coming up. And yeah, the championship is far from over, isn't it? Just because of that, there's so many points up for grabs.
I wonder what that weather's going to do in Barcelona. We'll find out this weekend.
I think it's going to rain.